Hello students, welcome back to the class. In the last classes we have discussed about the power and the compositions and the functions of Rajya Sabha. In this class we will continue the topic. So in the last classes we have mainly discussed about what are the compositions and how the members will be elected. So in the last classes we have discussed that the members are mainly elected from the member of legislative assembly and the member of union territories, and they were elected by the proportional representation. In this class, when we are talking about the composition of Rajya Sabha, so in the last classes we have discussed about composition and election. In this class we will discuss about qualification, sessions, quorum, presiding meetings, who will preside the meeting, and what are the special power of Rajya Sabha. This all are very very easy and very very interesting also, childrens. This is very very simple. Whenever you are writing any answers, side reading is very very important. Okay, in the exam also, whenever you are writing any answers, any type of answers, side readings are very very important point. And these are very easy. These are not so complicated. This point is very very easy. I'll go forward see here. So in the last classes, mainly when we have discussed about the composition of parliament, in which we have discussing now about Rajya Sabha. So now already in the last classes we have completed the compositions and elections of Rajya Sabha. Now we will study about the qualification. When we are talking about the qualification, about Article 84 of the Constitution deals with the qualification of Rajya Sabha. What are the qualifications which are required? Okay, which are very essential to become the member of Rajya Sabha. First one, you should be the citizen of India. To become the member of Rajya Sabha, you should be the citizen of India. If you are occupying any position, Indian position, either president, prime minister, first important thing is citizenship is very very important. So you should be the citizen of India. Second thing, to become the member of Rajya Sabha, you should be at least 30 years of age. Already we have discussed. Okay, 30 years of age. To become the member of Lok Sabha, 25 years. To become the member of Rajya Sabha, 30 years. To become the president or vice president, 35 years. Okay. Now, if you wanted to become the member of Rajya Sabha, you should possess all the qualifications which are required. You should possess other qualifications also. Not only the citizen and not only the 30 years, there are many other qualifications which are needed. So, you should possess all the qualifications which are required for membership of Rajya Sabha. And this all the qualifications are laid down according to the Representations of People Act 1951. So the qualification of Rajya Sabha we can find, which is laid down in the Representations of People Act 1951. So this qualification is very very important. So we have discussed about the qualification of Rajya Sabha according to the Article 84 of the Indian Constitution. Says that first you should be the citizen of India, very simple. You should complete 30 years of age. And you should possess other qualifications which are required for the member of Rajya Sabha, and you should and everything should be laid down. All these qualifications is laid down according to the Representations of People Act 1951. Okay, next come to the point. Now come to the point, this is completed. Now if you see tenure, tenures are nothing but terms. Okay, what is the total period of Rajya Sabha? So normally when you see the member of Rajya Sabha, terms will be 6 years. But the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house which cannot be dissolved. I already said you, the Rajya Sabha members, all the membership will not be dissolved. If you see the Lok Sabha, in Lok Sabha when you see the membership will be dissolved completely. After completing the fixed term, after the expiry of the term, 5 years, the membership also will be retired and everybody will be retired in the same time in Lok Sabha. But when we are talking about the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. Why? Because all the members will not retire suddenly. Okay, member will retire, but the Rajya Sabha house will never retire. Okay, so it is not a subject of dissolution. So all the members cannot be dissolved at the same time. So imagine that 6 years, only 1/3 of the members will be retired for every 2 years. Retirement will be there. Every 2 years, 1/3 of the members will be retired, and again new members will be appointed. Okay, so if you see that for 33% of members will be retired for every 2 years. Okay, so only 33 members will be retired, but all the members will not retire. Even though if they'll retire, again they will get new members. Okay, so that is one point. So But in that's why this is a permanent house, because all the members will not retire in the same time. Members will retire in Rajya Sabha, 33 members will retire only every 2 years, and the term of the member of Rajya Sabha will be 6 years. Okay, in that, when the term will complete, when the term will be completed, then all the members in Rajya Sabha will not retire. Only 33% of the member in Rajya Sabha will be retired for every 2 years, and that's why if you see, Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. And in Rajya Sabha, we can't find dissolutions will occur in the same time. All the people will not be dissolved. This is very simple, children. Okay, composition we have seen, elections, qualifications. Now sessions. Now sessions will go forward. So oath. When we are talking about the oath, all the member of Rajya Sabha members will take the oath in front of president. So most of the members will take the oath in front of president. So normally, whenever the members are taking their oath, they are taking in front of presidents only. Okay, that is one point. So here we have discussed some various important things, that all the members in the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house because all the members will not retire. The member of the term of Rajya Sabha member is very high when compared to all the members, because most of the members, the term will be only 5 years. The member of Rajya Sabha term will be 6 years. And all the members will be not retiring in the same time. Okay, only 33 members will be retired. Okay, 33 members will be retired for every 2 years. 1/3 of the members will be retired for every 2 years. That is one point. Next, we'll go forward here. Now, session. What are the who will preside the meeting? So, sessions are nothing but meeting. Who will conduct the meeting? So, either if you see Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, the common thing is president will preside over the meeting. He will summons, he will start, and he will end the meeting. Who will end the meeting? President. But particularly when we are talking about Rajya Sabha, the meeting will be conducted for every two meeting will be conducted for every 1 year. In 1 year, the meetings will be conducted 2 times in the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha meet 2 times in 1 year, and Rajya Sabha will continue, but Rajya Sabha will not dissolve. Dissolutions will not occur in Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha, all the members will be dissolved after 5 years, but the member of Rajya Sabha will not be dissolved after the 6 years. The now Vice President will preside over the meeting of Rajya Sabha. So when we are talking about the sessions, who will carry it out? For particularly Rajya Sabha, when we are talking, Vice President will act as a chairman of Rajya Sabha. Okay, the Vice President will act as the chairman of Rajya Sabha, we can find. And Vice President act as the ex-official officers. Okay, he is one of the ex-official officers, we can find. Vice President act as the ex-official officers. Now imagine that if there is no Vice President, if there is no Vice President, then Deputy Chairman can act as a chairman. Who is the chairman of Rajya Sabha is Vice President. Imagine that if there is no Vice President, if there will be no Vice President, in the absence of Vice President, then who will conduct the meeting? If in the absence of Vice President, then Deputy Chairman, okay, Deputy Chairman will conduct the meeting. Okay, this is called Deputy Chairman. Okay, Deputy Chairman will conduct the meeting. In the absence of Deputy Chairman, imagine that in Rajya Sabha there is no Vice President. In the absence of Vice President or Deputy Chairman, who will conduct the meeting? So the meeting will be conducted by any member of Rajya Sabha member. Any senior members or any member of Rajya Sabha members can able to conduct the meeting. This is one point. Now quorum. Now we are going forward. Session qualification completed. Session completed. Now we are in quorum. In quorum, what we have to study? Quorum is nothing but what is the minimum strength which is needed to conduct the meeting. Okay, if you want to start any session, what is the minimum strength which should be required to conduct any type of session? That is called as quorum. Okay, so quorum is also a very important thing when we are learning about Rajya Sabha. Now, the minimum person should present in the house, that is called as quorum. 1/3, 1/10 of the members should present in the house to conduct the meeting. So whenever the meeting is going on or session is going on, and when the session is called off, then at least 1/3 of the members should participate in the meeting. 1/3 of the members should present in the meeting. Okay. Now that depends upon completely the presiding officer. So presiding officers, in the sense, either Vice President is a presiding officer. Presiding officer will decide whether to conduct the meeting or not, even though if the strength is 1/3, 1/10 or less than that, then the presiding officers will decide whether to continue the meeting or whether to end the meeting. That will be completely under the control of presiding officer. This is one point. So, children, we have discussed about composition in the earlier classes when we have discussed about composition and election. In this class, mainly we have concentrated on qualification, sessions and quorum of Rajya Sabha. So, when we have discussed about qualification, we have discussed that Article 84 of the Indian Constitution explains about the qualification of Rajya Sabha, and to become the member of Rajya Sabha, you should be the citizen of India, you should complete 30 years of age. You should possess all the qualification which are needed, other qualification which are important to become the member of Rajya Sabha, and that all the qualifications should be laid down according to the Representation of People Act 1951. When we are talking about the 10 years, the term, the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house and Rajya Sabha will not be dissolved. Why it is a permanent house? Because 1/3 of the members will be retired for every 2 years. Every 2 years the members will be retired, so 33% of the members will be retired for every 2 years, but all the members will not be retired in the same time. That is one point. All the members in the Rajya Sabha will not be retired in the same time, only 1/3 of the members will be retired. Okay, that is one point. Next, the member of Rajya Sabha, when they will be selected, then they will take the oath in front of president. Oath is nothing but for servicing. Okay, oath is nothing but a promise before service. You have to promise before taking the service, you have to make a promise that you will discharge your work efficiently. So that is called as oath. So whenever if you are taking an oath, the member of Rajya Sabha will take the oath in front of president. Okay. Sessions we have discussed, meeting, who will conduct the meeting. The meeting of both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha will be under the control of president. Actually president is the head. So whenever he will conduct joint sitting of both the house, joint sitting in the sense both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha will gather, that meeting will be conducted by president. But normally when we are talking about Rajya Sabha, the presiding officer of Rajya Sabha is a chairman, in the sense vice president. Vice president will conduct the meeting. So most of the meeting will be conducted by vice president because he is the chairman of Rajya Sabha. Now this meeting will be conducted for 1 year, 2 times the meeting will be conducted. Rajya Sabha will meet 2 times in 1 year, and this Rajya Sabha will continue. Okay, the meeting will never stop. Okay, it will be continue. Okay, because there is no end of Rajya Sabha, this is a permanent house, because all the members will not be retired in the same time, there is no dissolution. Rajya Sabha will not be dissolved. Okay, the Rajya Sabha will not be dissolved, and that's why Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. We have discussed. Then the presiding officer of Rajya Sabha is vice president. Vice president is the presiding officer of Rajya Sabha, and he acts as an ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. Okay, ex official chairman of Rajya Sabha. Now what will happen? Now suppose just now I explained you, vice president act as a presiding officer. In the absence, this is also very important, if there is no president, in the absence of vice president, who will conduct the meeting? The meeting will be conducted by deputy chairman. Children, in Rajya Sabha, along with chairman, a deputy chairman also appointed. So in the absence of chairman, the deputy chairman will conduct the meeting. Imagine that, what if the chairman also is absent and deputy chairman is also absent, in that condition then who will conduct the meeting? The meeting will be conducted by any person can conduct the meeting. So quorum, we have discussed about quorum. The minimum strength which is required to conduct the session is called as quorum. In this quorum we have seen that 1/10 of the member, 1/10 of the member should be presented in the meeting for conducting a quorum. Presiding officer will decide whether to start or whether to end or whether to cancel the meeting. That is completely depends upon presiding officer. If the strength is very very less, then presiding officer will normally take the decision to end the meeting. Strength should be at least 1/10. Whenever any meeting will be conducted, the strength should be at least 1/10. Okay, strength is very very important. If the strength is less than 1/10, the presiding officer normally what he will do? He will stop the meeting, he will not conduct the meeting. So that completely depends upon presiding officer whether to start or whether to end. So children, in this point we have discussed about qualification, session, quorum. Okay, quorum also we have discussed. Okay, in the next classes we will discuss about some other topics about the composition of Rajya Sabha. Okay, so we will discuss about the topics, and these topics are very very easy. Okay, this is so easy, very very important and very easy topic. Okay, so we will meet you in the next class, students. Thank you very much.